Hi, my name is Alenka. I'm a children's librarian with the Chicago Public Library. Welcome to this TinkerCad tutorial on how to make a keychain. What you're looking at right now is the TinkerCad screen that you see when you click this Learn button in the top right-hand corner. It gives you these three options for starters, lessons, and projects. The keychain one is a project. And then with projects, you have to hit See all projects here. And then we're gonna scroll down. We're looking for a project called Name That Keychain. Ah, right here. So each project gives you a little description of what it's about. This is about making a keychain. I'm not gonna read it to you. And then if it has multiple parts, you have to hit start from the first part. Cool, so each project shows you a normal TinkerCAD work plan. You also have this list of instructions on the left side. And they give you pictures for what your object is supposed to look like. You can always click on these and make them bigger. So here's some sample work letters on the work plane. I'm gonna go ahead and hit next because the first step isn't really a step. So first we need to select our letters. In the sample, this person made their last name into a keychain. I work at the Thomas Hughes Children's Library and we abbreviate it to THCL. So I'm gonna go over here to basic shapes. And I'm going to select text and numbers. Sorry. And then we're going to scroll down until we get those letters, THCL. So T, H, C, and O. And I'm going to zoom in so you can see better. Okay, and then I'll hit next. So first we want to align all of our letters so that they're all sitting flat on this bottom line. It looks like I kind of did a good job of eyeballing it, but we're gonna use the alignment tool just to make sure. First I have to select all of my letters. So I'm gonna hold down the left clicker on my mouse, drag a rectangle around all of them, and that selects all of them together. And then up here on the top right, TinkerCAD has a bunch of tools. If you hover your mouse on them and just stop, it'll give you the name for each tool. So align or alignment looks like this little bar graph. And alignment gives you these little black poles that show you how you can move your letters around to line them up with each other. To get them all sitting flat on this bottom line, I need to click the pole on the very bottom and then it's gonna gray out and now they are all lined up. So I wasn't quite in a perfect line. And then when I'm done using alignment, I can click anywhere on the work plane and it will close out that tool. Okay. Now the instructions ask us to click on the second letter in your word and then use the arrow keys to move that letter closer to the next one. You have some different options for how you can move objects around on the work plane. The easiest is to just click with your mouse and drag, but it's harder to control, so I think I actually moved my H up a little bit, so I'm gonna hit the back arrow. If I use my arrow keys, I'm only moving one direction along the x-axis, and I won't ruin the fact that I just aligned all my letters together. So I'm gonna move the H over, gonna scooch the C. I want them to overlap a little bit. The instructions say they should overlap by about a millimeter. It doesn't have to be exact. The way your letters overlap will vary depending on the shape and they might look a little goofy. So that's not too bad. It's a little hard to see, but I can tell from this light line here that the T and the H are about a millimeter overlapped. I think I wanna move the C in more, but I don't wanna move it in super far to the H. So down here on the bottom right, I can change my snap grid. Your snap grid is basically what all of these tiny little squares equal. So right now they equal 1 millimeter. I'm gonna change it to 0.25. And now when I click on the C and I hit my arrow key, it only moves 0.25 millimeters over. Well, I think that's pretty good. And then because I moved the C, I'm also gonna move the L. Yeah, that looks pretty good to me. So I'm gonna continue to next step. Okay, so this looks pretty good. I can make out the THCL okay. This person, their name got kind of goofy when they put it all together. The E's and the L's kind of blended into these weird boxes. So their recommendation for making your word easier to read is, oops, I skipped a step. First, we have to group everything together. So I'm going to select all my letters. And then up here, this is the group symbol, the square and the circle merged. And now all of my letters are one object, so I can even move them center so you can see them better. Now, even though I made them one object, I can still edit each individual letter. I'm going to double click, and then my object gets this nice red rectangle underneath, and I can select just the H. And the instructions recommend lowering the second letter just maybe a millimeter or so, so I want to change my snap grid back to 1 millimeter. And then I can use this white square. Here, if I change the view entirely sideways, you can see this white square is for the top of the letter and it's how tall it is. So I can drag that down just 1 millimeter. And then I can do the same thing with the L. So now they'll have a little bit different definition from each other. Cool. Okay, now we're gonna make the key ring loop. So I have text and numbers up over here still. I have to click on that, go to basic shapes. And then they use a cylinder to do this. So I'm going to grab the cylinder. And the instructions ask you to size it to 4 millimeters square and 3 millimeters tall. So resizing something square means that these measurements in the square underneath the cylinder are all going to be exactly the same. There's a couple ways to do this. One of the easier ones is if I hold down the shift key on my keyboard, and then I click one of these white squares and drag, it's resizing the cylinder proportionally or the same on all sides. So I can just drag it down until I get to the 4. And now it's 4 millimeters everywhere. But I need it to be 3 millimeters tall. So I can use this box to drag it down. Oops, actually can't see that. Yep, to 3 millimeters. So that's one way to resize something square. I need a second cylinder. And this one I need to be 2 millimeters square. That's really tiny. I find it kind of hard to control the shape when you get that small. The smaller you get, I think it's a little hard to control the mouse. So my other option for resizing something this way is I can just click in these boxes and I can hit 2 and then the Enter key. And then as long, oh, it did both sides for me, that's nice. As long as both of these say 2, then it is 2 millimeters all around, but I need it to be 5 millimeters tall. So I can actually do that for the top measurement too. If I click the little square on the top, I can click in here, hit 5, hit Enter, and it gets taller too. I need to make the second cylinder a hole. So when you click on any shape, it gives you these two options in the little shape editor. Right now it's solid. If I hit hole, now my cylinder is this cool clear color. So it's like a donut hole. Think of it this way. So I'm going to move my cylinder, my whole cylinder, kind of in the middle. I think that's sort of in the middle of my other one, but I want it to be perfectly center. So here the instructions tell me to align them vertically so that they have the same center. So I'm going to select both, click on my alignment tool again. Oh, I did pretty good. So to make sure it's center, I need both these little poles in the center of each side to be gray, and they are, so I eyeballed that pretty well. If you do not, just click on the little poles, make sure they're gray, and then your object should be good to go. I can select both again, group them, and now I made my donut hole. Here's my donut. Now for the last part, I believe they recommend using your arrow keys again to move your cylinder into the corner of the letter where you want your key ring to be. You might want to readjust your snap grid on this again. Yeah, because so the T on my THL kind of cuts into the center, and if I have it that way, I'm a little worried that it will be hard to clip something onto the key ring. So I might nudge it out a tiny bit with the 0.25 snap grid. And then I can group both objects together. And that's it, that's my key ring. If you hit done, there is a second part to this lesson, but all it does is give you customization options. So things you can consider, this cylinder key ring doesn't have to be your key ring. It might be a little harder to clip something onto if you use another shape, But you can use that same method of making a hole in the center with pretty much anything. Like, let's say I want a heart keyring. Here is a big heart. I'm going to shrink it down. And then I can get another heart. Shrink it down. Make it a hole. And I can align them again. Whoops. Doesn't help if the hole is not on top of the other shape or taller than it. Okay, now I can align them and group them. And I could use this as my key ring instead. I could also put this shape on the end of my keychain and just have a heart. So however you want to customize your keychain is great. I just wouldn't make it super duper long because then it won't be very functional. But that's it. That is the keychain lesson. And I hope you guys send us some keychains. Thanks.